So good morning to everyone who's watching this mass in the internet. And we've been in this lockdown for 2 months now. I remember it was in March 11 when the World Health Organization declared that this coronavirus is a pandemic. And we've been in lockdown mode for 2 months, 2 months now. And that's why right now, it's really great news that, you know, the government here in Canada and also in other countries are starting to reopen. And they have these phases, like phase one, phase two, and phase three. And right now here in Canada, we're doing phase one. And so we're going to start opening golf courses, tennis courts, and other places, right? And that's why for me, when I heard that, I just got so excited. I emailed my companion brother priest and seminarian, and I asked them, when are we going to play tennis? Okay, and because I love playing tennis. And so it's great news, you know, because we've been in this lockdown mode for 2 months now, and a lot of us are experiencing what they call cabin fever, right? And so it's good to go out to connect with people. And that's why there's a saying that is very true. Absence makes the heart grow fonder. You know, and because the absence of coming to church, the absence of connecting with other people, it makes us long even more to connect, you know, to go to church. So I can't wait for phase two and phase three. I know the churches, I think we're in phase three, so it will take a few more weeks. But also we have to be careful, right? We can't just go and, you know, not practice the safety protocols, because what I'm afraid of is that we would have like a second wave in this pandemic, and then if we have a second wave, a third wave, we're going to shut down again. So we have to practice safety protocols, because this virus, the thing with this virus is that we know that this virus is infectious, okay, and it's deadly. A lot of people have died already. And because of that, you know, we're really practicing social distancing, okay? And so we need to be careful. But you know, there's another virus that is also very infectious, but not deadly, okay? You know, this virus is life-giving. This virus connects you with other people. And this is the type of virus that we need to spread around. And this virus is called the love virus, okay? And we need to spread this around. And just like how the negative impact of coronavirus in the world, when we spread this love virus, it will have a positive effect in our lives, in our relationship, but also in society and the whole world. I would like to show you a trailer of a documentary about a sister. Her name is Sister Claire Crockett, okay? So I want you to watch this video, because the reason why I'm showing you this video is because this person, this sister, caught this love virus. And when she caught this love virus, she couldn't help but infect other people with this virus. So watch this trailer of this documentary called All or Nothing.
De un momento a otro el terremoto y el edificio de las hermanas se cayó completamente.
Era como que no hubiera existido nunca un edificio de cuatro pisos, como que solo hubiera existido la terraza.
Solo me agaché y empezamos a caer.
Seguíamos buscando para ver si alguien contestaba, si había vida, pero ya no escuchamos nada.
Y de repente me vino muy fuerte la hermana Claire. Yo experimentaba que ella me decía, estoy bien, no os preocupéis por mí, estoy muy bien.
And everything she'd done was drama. She wanted to go to Hollywood and she was going to be a great star. And Claire was one of those people, she just stood out.
She was a very charismatic, crazy character.
And she was like a live wire, very vibrant and full of fun.
I always thought that she would be in film somewhere on a longer name, lately. I thought TV was her life just was so.
I wanted to be famous, and even though it sounds like a dream or whatever, that I might have lost the plot of that, but that's, I wanted to be famous. Front of the cross, I think that I nailed into the cross, it was my fault. And seeing this, I was like, I have to change. I fell in love with Jesus Christ, I fell in love with him because, what can I say, that he stole my heart.
Her happiness changed to joy.
Everyone loved her. The elderly, children, the children's parents, the poor. But she was very clear. She didn't want them to come to her, but to the Lord.
I just owe a lot to her, just for the salvation of my soul.
My last memory of Sister Claire is her giving me a hug goodbye and saying, until heaven.
En mi vida siempre ha sido o todo o nada, o actriz famosa o nada. Y yo entendí lo que él me estaba pidiendo era una llamada a seguirle a él totalmente, dejando todo, dejando nada por todo en realidad.
When I watched this this movie, I really encourage you to watch this movie as a family. It's called All or Nothing. It's a story about the sister Claire Crockett, and she was born in Northern Ireland in 1981, and as you saw in the trailer there, she wanted to be an actress, but not just an actress. She wanted to be a famous actress, not just in Ireland but all over the world. And she lived a very sinful life, you know, seeking pleasure and partying, drinking, a lot of that. And she went to this pilgrimage to Spain to during Holy Week to go to this organized by this community called Servant Sisters of the Home of the Mother, a religious order with a particular apostolate of evangelizing young people. And it was through that Holy Week, you know, Good Friday, when she kissed the foot of the cross, of Jesus on the cross, where she experienced this. She said this, she wrote this in her testimony. I only remember that I kissed the nail that went through the feet of Jesus and received the grace to see that God had died for me on the cross, for my sins, for my vanities, for my infidelities, for my impurity. I saw how I nailed the Lord to the cross, and that the only way that I could console him was to give him my life. And of course, it wasn't an instant conversion that happened there. She continued to struggle with her sinful life. But in year 2001, she decided to join this religious community in Spain, and for her it was a struggle. It was a struggle. Now I'm quoting this from The Word Among Us. She's featured on this missalette, and here it says here that she continues to struggle even in religious life because she has this great desire to become famous, okay, and a famous nun. But as time went on, she cared less and less about fame and more about loving the people around her. Okay? And it says here in this article, as tirelessly as she had given herself to a life of pleasure, she now devoted herself to a life of service and evangelization. And in the article it says, if there's one word to describe Sister Claire Crockett, it's fun. It's fun. It says here that she made people laugh. She carried a guitar and sang songs energetically. She's the favorite of children. She's the favorite of children. Why? Because they admire her not only for her lively demeanor, but for the way she encouraged them to seek Jesus. Okay, and what happened there was that, you know, she was in Ecuador serving there. And in April 2016, there was a flood that happened there, and then there was an earthquake. In the school that she was serving, it 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 collapsed. And she was caught inside there, and there she died. When I watched this movie, this documentary about her life, I was in tears. I was really in tears. I was so inspired. And I remember praying to God. I said, I want to be a male version of this sister. Okay? I want to spread this love virus to people that I will meet. You know, spread that love, spread that joy, spread that peace. I know I have a long way to go. I still struggle. But that's my desire. And for all of us, we're all called to spread this love virus. Whether you are an extrovert or an introvert, all of us are called. Okay? But the thing is, we need to contract this virus first. Either we have it or we don't have it, right? Like with this coronavirus. Either we have this coronavirus or we don't have this coronavirus. We need to experience this love from God, who is the source of this virus, of this love virus. And maybe for some of you, you're struggling. Maybe for you, God's love is just head knowledge, you know, and you haven't really experienced it in your life. Maybe you're living a sinful life and you struggle. You know, you doubt whether God loves you. Okay? Now, I would like to suggest three things to you. And I use the acronym PRO, P-R-O, for easy to remember. If you're struggling, if you haven't experienced this love from God, the first is pray. Pray. Okay? And Father Bob, the founder of the Companions of the Cross religious community that I belong to, he said, he would say this prayer, Lord, if you are real, show me. Say that prayer. If you haven't, if you're doubting whether God exists, or whether you're doubting whether God loves you, say this powerful prayer. Lord, if you are real, show me. So that's the first one, P, pray. The second one is remove, R, okay? Remove. Remove any obstacles so that you will have this conscious contact with this love from God. You know, God never stopped loving us. The thing is, we put a lot of like obstacles between us and God. Whether that's anxiety, whether that's a deep-seated attachment like addiction, whether that's resentment, whether that's living in sin, all these are obstacles for us to experience God, and we need to remove that. It's like wearing a mask. Okay, like people are wearing masks because they don't want to contract this coronavirus. But for us to contract this love virus, we need to remove anything so that we would be able to experience that love from God. So that's R. The last one is O. O stands for obey. We need to obey. Okay? In our gospel today, it says there, in our gospel today, in John chapter 14, verse 21, it says, the one who has my commandments and keeps them is the one who loves me. And the one who loves me will be loved by my Father, and I will love them and reveal myself to them. If we're obeying God, we will experience His love. It's not that, you know, if we disobey God, God stopped loving us. No, it's not that. Because when we're disobeying God, we're putting a block between us and Him. And when we're obeying Him, His commandment, and what's His commandment? Is to love. His commandment is to love. So when we're obeying God, when we're obeying His commandment, we are loving, and when we have this conscious contact with God, who is love. And when we experience this love, when we contract this love virus, it will transform us. And it will overflow. And what will happen, like it will transform your relationship with other people. People will see that. Just like in the life of this sister, Sister Claire Crackett, people notice that. People notice the love, the joy, the peace that she was experiencing. And she was infecting a lot of people her sisters in her community, the children that she ministers to, all of the people, she was infecting them with this love virus. So I really encourage you to do this three, P-R-O, pro, okay? P stands for pray. R, remove any obstacles. O, obey. Obey God. And when you do these three things, you will experience the love of God in a very powerful way. And it will transform you. I guarantee you, it will transform you. It will transform your relationship with others. And when you do that, it will transform the world. And it's infecting one person at a time. Imagine a lot of people being infected by this love virus and also infecting others. It will transform our families. It will transform this society. It will transform this country. It will transform this world. So I encourage you, okay, expose yourself. Expose yourself so that you will be able to be infected by this love virus from God. And start infect and be a pro. Be a pro in infecting others with this love virus. And you will see how this world will be transformed.